start out because I saw that you participated in hashtag Petty Post too.
Oh, yeah. You know, every once in a while, you just have to come out from hiding and let them know.
Because
you know,
on Monday was the MTV Movie and
TV Awards.
TV Awards. Correct. Love and Hip Hop won for the reality.
Reality royalty. That was the category that we won.
Yes.
Yes.
And it seemed like a few people had some issues.
Well, you know, they didn't hide them well. Yes, because honestly, it didn't bother me that much. I was just like, dang, we that salty?
Yeah.
You know, and listen, I don't want to keep dwelling on it because I would be just as guilty as they are if I continue to dwell. But it was very disappointing, very disheartening, very illuminating, you know, just to kind of see the very open and outright reaction to that win. I just feel like, you know, we're all part of the same Viacom family, and they certainly could have hidden it, waited till they got home.
Yeah.
You know, but you know what? If it meant that much to you that you had to get it out in the moment, do you?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
But the truth of the matter is we won, and that's it, point blank, period.
Now, we've seen within different franchises of Love and Hip Hop, you've been a champion for diversity and inclusion.
Mm-hmm.
You've had trans women on your show. There's been people of different economic backgrounds. How important is it for you when it comes to casting to keep it diverse?
It's incredibly important because I think what we're trying to show is that we come in a very diverse, colorful, expressive, full range as a people, right?
Mm-hmm.
We are not monolithic. I say this all the time. None of us have the same experience, the same upbringing, the same, you know, influences that make us who we are and that, inspire the way we react to certain things. And so it's really important that we show that and we embrace that and we allow it to be, right? And I get it when people say, oh, there aren't enough, you know, representations. But I think it is unrealistic and it's a disservice to ourselves if we do not allow all of the representations to have an opportunity and a platform, you know?
I totally agree. Motown is being honored tonight with a huge award.
Oh my God, yes.
It's going to be a hard question. Are you ready?
Oh, Cocktail Song.
Let's do your top three.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Anything by any of the number, anything by Diana Ross, anything. I mean, like, come on.
I know.
It's so hard.
Yeah.
You know, there's so many hits over, and just everything about that era, right? But if I had to pick one thing, I would have to say it's Berry Gordy. And that inspiration and this his story and the barriers and the ceilings that he shattered, you know, for us all to be able to have an opportunity to be in this business, right? So it isn't about a song, it's about the movement that he built.
Thank you, Mona.
Hey, I'm Mona Scott Young, and you're watching That Grape Juice.